Hello, myself Sampreet Patel, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today, in this session, we are going to learn about HTML in web technologies. So today we'll be starting with the introduction of HTML. At the end of this session or video, the students will be able to recognize different HTML tags and they'll be able to design a basic web page using HTML. These are the things that will be covered in this video. So you'll be introduced to what is web technology and HTML. You'll be introduced to HTML basics, its attributes, and its headings and paragraphs. So web technology is nothing but a combination of different markup languages, scripts, or frameworks which are used to develop a website or a web apps. So basically the method which is used to used by the computers to communicate with each other with using internet is web technology. So what is HTML? HTML is a hypertext markup language. It describes the structure of a web page. It consists of series of elements, and these elements define how the web page or the contents on the web page should look like. The elements are represented by tags, and each tag label are the pieces of content such as heading, paragraph, images, tables, etc., which you see on a web page. Now, in this current era, web technology is playing a very important role. In any domain, it is very important that your business or your idea is published and made public. And the best thing to do this is building a website or a web app. So, starting with basic things of HTML. So, we'll see HTML page is a markup language which uses tags. So there are four basic tags which you require before you put on any elements on a web page. So first tag is the HTML tag. HTML tags are enclosed in arrow brackets. Each tag will have a corresponding closing tag. So this is the very important tag, HTML tag. Everything in a web page is written inside an HTML tag. After that, we have a title tag. So this tag helps you to display a title of your web page. This title is displayed on the tab of a browser. So we'll say web page title. After that, we have a head tag and its corresponding closing head tag. Okay, head tag is used to import different scripts or script files like JavaScript or CSS, which are used to or helps in supporting an HTML page. So anything you want to import is written in a head tag, or you can directly write a script using a script tag inside the head tag. Okay, so this is the use of script head tag. Now the important tag is a body tag. So everything that you see on a web page is written inside a body tag. Now whatever is inside a start of a tag and the end of a tag is the element of that tag. So elements tell the browser how to display the content. Okay. So the most important thing is element and its attributes. So all the attributes or all the tags can have attributes, and attributes give us more information about the element. So for example, here we'll say we give a attribute style, okay? So we say background color and we give a color, say C0, 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 and we end it with semicolon. So I'll just run this file. Okay, see, the background of this particular web page is gray and the title is web page title, which we have given in a title tag, okay, here. So if I remove this particular style, save it, and again run, so see, the background is now white, okay? So moving on, the two basic things we learned today is the headings and the paragraph. So HTML have a default headings from H1 to H6, okay? So H1 is the most important, used for most important heading, while as H6 is used for the least important headings. So we'll just see, I'll just give heading 1. Okay, I'll just copy it. And 5, okay? I'll just change this to 2. So you'll come to know what are the headings, and headings will have a default font size and default structure defined by the HTML. So if you want to change, you can change it using attributes. Okay. So I'll just say 2, heading 3, heading 4, and heading 5, and this will be heading 6. Okay, I'll run this. See, this is the least important heading and its font size is the minimum, and this is the most important heading where the font size is maximum. Now you can change the font size or using the attribute. All the attributes are to be defined in the start tag of that particular tag. So say style equal to will define its font size colon, I'll say 20 pixels, I'll save it, I'll refresh this page. So see, the font size of the heading 6 is changed, but the default font size are provided by the HTML. The another important thing is paragraph, where you have to write a huge amount of content on your website. We use a paragraph. Paragraph also has a default font size. So I'll say, welcome to Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. This is one of the renowned or famous engineering colleges in Maharashtra and India. Okay, so I'll refresh this page. So see, here the content from the paragraph is been displayed, saying welcome to Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. This is one of the famous engineering colleges in Maharashtra and India. Okay. Okay. So this was all about HTML. We have seen different tags like HTML tag, after that title tag, head tag and body tag. Whatever you want to display on an HTML page should be written inside the body tag. and all the other tags should be inside an HTML tag. I hope you have understood. Now, I want you to design a basic web page displaying your contact information. So it might contain name, mobile number, email address, ID, and postal address. So take a few minutes and try to design using what we have learned till now. Okay, so see, this is what we have designed. So contact details is given in heading H1 and all other is in H3. So if we see the code for this, I'll just open it with Notepad++. So see, here the title is Samprit Patel. Okay, now we have used background color as gray. So this is the hash code for gray. Then we have used H1 tag for displaying a contact detail heading, and other all details have been put in H3 tag. So I hope you have understood what is HTML, why it is useful, what is web technology, and the basic HTML tags. So these are some references you can follow up. Head First HTML5 Programming by O'Reilly Media and HTML and CSS, second edition by Pragmatic Bookshelf. You can follow up and learn some HTML attributes for the tags. Thank you.